Today we're going to shuck a 14 terabyte Western Digital Easystore drive with the purpose of finding out whether the internal disk is a red label or a white label. We'll also examine the information on the label and the disk itself once we take it out. The design of the Easystore enclosure hasn't changed for the past several years, so I won't show you the detailed step-by-step procedure on how to shuck it. Instead, I refer you to a previously published video where I removed the disk from an 8TB Easystore enclosure as a link in the top right corner if you want more thorough instructions. But first things first, let's hook it up to the computer to determine the model number that we should expect to be inside. After loading it up in Crystal Disk Info, it tells us that it should be a model number WD140EMFZ. Let's open it up to find out for sure. So, I'll give you a very quick refresher in this video. You'll need guitar picks, or a cut-up credit card, or a spudger, an expired gift card, a Phillips head screwdriver, and a pair of pliers, or a Torx screwdriver. Slide four guitar picks, or the credit card pieces, into the rear seams of the case at these locations. Here's another view from a different orientation. Wedge and pry the case apart using the expired gift card at the top and bottom of the curved part. Slide the disc out, unscrew the PCB fastener, take off the plastic light pipe, slide off the USB SATA connector, remove the bumpers, and unscrew the Torx screws, either with the screwdriver or with the pliers. And the internal disc is a white label model WD140EMFZ. Based on online documents from Western Digital and other sources, the numbers and the first letter tells us it's a 14TB 3.5-inch disk. The second letter means Western Digital branded. The third letter is the RPM, which deviates from the Western Digital documents. However, Crystal Disk Info reveals that it's 5400 RPM. And finally, the last letter means that it's a SATA 6 gigabit per second with 22-pin SATA connector. Unfortunately, there's nothing on the label itself that's immediately apparent in telling us whether this is a helium drive or how much cache it has. But hey, at least it makes it clear that this disk is intended for internal use. Let me know in the comments if you have any further information about this disk, and I'll update the description. In terms of the model you receive, your mileage may vary, of course. I did in fact purchase two of these 14TB Easystores, and the second disc is again a white label of the same model. Looking at the side of the disc, note that the middle mounting hole is missing. Here's a comparison with a typical 3.5-inch drive with the middle hole. This is due to the larger number of platters internally, preventing a hole from being drilled in that area. Just one last note. If you use this disk as internal storage for your computer, and you find that it doesn't spin up, you may have a power supply that sends out a 3.3-volt signal to shut down the disk. I've linked to my video that provides a simple, non-destructive fix here in the upper right corner. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.